Pokemon Ultra Sun. Today we're headed on our way to the next trial. We're on our Mudsdale right here, a trusty Mudsdale. We actually have one on our team, so I'm gonna pretend I am the one taking us around on this journey. I'm skipping over this grass because I can. Oh, it's you again, hello. Well, young Sapley, we keep running into one another, don't we? When I'm feeling stuck on my research into regional variants and total Pokemon, that's when I come out for a spot of Mantine surfing. It's the secret to feeling all recharged. Though it does get my go-go that I can't seem to ever beat that kimono-clad cad when it comes to the ranking board. Anyway, you keep collecting them totem stickers and do your island challenge. Yeah, I'll be around Hee Hee Beach and Mikel Island if you ever need me. I actually do have enough totem stickers, but I've just been lazy with actually going back to them. I don't think I'll actually be using totem Pokemon on this adventure. At least I don't think I will, so I haven't gone back to them. Okay, BP shop, okay, battle points, beach points. Okay, I'm wondering actually are there different rewards here than in the other BP shop at the other beach. Oh, she makes the same speech every time. I think that's pretty similar, about the same. Let's check this one. Oh, teaches a moo, what you got? Oh, I could use some of these. Oh, there's some good moves in here. They even got stuff like Ice Punch and Drill Run. I might need to consider coming back here for some of these. And we get a revive as well. What else is going on the beach right here? Is it just surfing? I have nowhere to go though. Like, where does this take me to? Okay, so this is another beach spot. Hey, Ozzy, you feel like taking a little trip across the ways of Mantine? This is the beach spot. What's that boy there teaching you to surf? Told me about moves, not good. I don't know if I'll hop on it right now. We did check out Mantine surfing in another episode, so we might pass this time. I guess I'll open the bottle. I hope I don't get mauled by these slow pokes at the same time. At whoever is reading this, I will be very grateful if you could deliver this letter to Nanoa, a trainer on Ula-Ula Island of Alola. Should be on Maui City's Keep. And if you could challenge him to a Pokemon battle, you'll be doing me a favor. I will go myself, but I figured you could get him warmed up for me. Just kidding, of course. No. Can I pick it up, or is it just gonna hang out here? I guess the Slowpokes are taking care of that business. Why is this Garrett watching me take the beer? Is he scaring me a little bit? I'm just taking these berries, don't mind me. I'm not doing anything bad, nothing against the law right here. You can look, but you can't touch. Or actually, you can touch, but you can't catch. All the Slowpoke and the speech are managed and protected by the... Oh! I thought you were worried about these berries the way you were staring at them. I was a little spooked. But it's safe. Lots of people drop things when they're making their way along the beach. You should have Stalin try to search out treasures. Speaking of which, actually... Oh! He's sniffing something with a snoop! And Diet Ball! Oh, he's sniffing something else! What else is out here? Wait! It was almost... Wait, it's almost... It's like right here somewhere! We've gone too far! Oh, right here! Oh, Pearl, we can get some money from this! Alright, what else is on this beach? Just get it out for me, buddy! What are we sniffing over here? Oh! A big Pearl, more money! I do want more money, actually, so this is very helpful and convenient. Anything else I'm missing out here on the shores? Anything over by the Slowpokes, maybe? I bet those Slowpokes are hiding some treasure for me. I knew it! The closer we get to the Slowpokes, the more treasure. There actually is more treasure. What else are you guys hiding from me? Of course they would hide this. What are you hiding, officer? Looks like there's a totem sticker on him, but there isn't. Alright, let's get out of here. We had a quick peek at the beach, but we got a trial to go find. Oh wait, I saw a trainer over this way and I want to go back and see them. this mountain right here just by going over there, but there's this trainer here. Come here, let's do something good with our Pokemon. I wanted to battle her because I battled almost every trainer on this route and she needs to be taken down. Swimmer Sarah would like to battle. She's got a cute haircut. And she's got a Starmie. Who have I got out front right now? Lulu! Lulu's perfect for this mission. Thank gosh for Lulu. Let's go straight for the Giga Train and finish this all fast. Oh no, we're too slow. Maybe I should give Lulu the quick paw so that Lulu can go a little bit quicker during these matches. But Lulu's a little bit too slow. But stronger. At least in terms of type advantages. The fun ends immediately if you're too strong. Sorry about that, Lulu just can't. Lulu can't help himself. I'm sorry about that. Oh, we got a pee-pee up over here, that's helpful. And nothing else. Okay, I didn't have to use my sniffing thing. I could just sense that was there. And one last oasis before the desert ends. Safi! Phew, that Togedemaru was strong, but I managed to get to the child too. Maybe even managed to get a bit stronger, eh? I heard from Soft Girls just how you just breezed through that trial yourself, Safi. I struggled a little bit. You're something else. I know you should take this. Oh, thanks, Hal. You're so helpful. You only have one volume, don't you? Haven't you ever heard the expression that silence is golden? Yeah, he's back. Did you ever learn the expression that if you got nothing nice to say, then don't say it at all, hmm? Listen, Team Skull is looking for a Pokemon called Cosmo. Do you two know anything, what? No, not that we tell you. So you do know something. Look, Cosmo isn't even a strong Pokemon. But it has the potential to summon Pokemon so terrifyingly strong that you don't even know. If something like that happened, it would be a disaster for Alola. A disaster? Like a real disaster? Then what are we supposed to do about it? Protect it. If you do know where Cosmo is, or if you do find anything out, just keep it safe. I know I might be working for Team Skull right now, so you may not trust me or care, but I'm going to tell you this just once. You have to protect Cosmo, no matter what. I still don't even understand how Team Skull found out about Cosmo in the first place. What do you mean, no matter what? You're just gonna leave us hanging? He always leaves us hanging, come on! As if they're really looking for Cosmo, then is Lily gonna be okay? I don't really get what's going on, but we gotta keep them both safe, right? Then I know what I'm gonna do. Take on the next child's chain up my partner. Look, I know Gizmo is saying all those things, but I really want to complete my island challenge. And help people learn about Pokemon battling. And I don't know, I've just got this feeling. I've gotta make sure you really get what my partner's feeling too. I like how he's like, we should protect Lily, but yeah, I'm gonna do my trials first. I hope Lily and Abby aren't in trouble. I hope not. Okay, this is where Gladion came out of. What was he doing here? Maybe he was getting some lemonade from the lemonade stall. Well, we're gonna get some lemonade too. Well, we had the opportunity, no, I'm good. What kind of terrible trainer leaves behind a sweet Pokemon like that? That Pokemon in the next guest room has been waiting for its trainer forever. Oh no, what Pokemon is it? Can I take it home? Oh, they're making me feel bad already. Oh, wait, hold on. This. Oh, yes, totem sticker. Now go. Oh, 50 of them. Special Oak wants to talk to you, is it? Oh, well, hello there. It's me, Samson Oak. I see you've collected some totem stickers. You should come stop by Hee Hee Beach. Will do. Just not right now. Oh, still full. Phew. Looks lonely and sad. Is this one of those side missions where I'm supposed to find his trainer? Oh, who was in this room? Who would leave behind such a precious cutie? Oh, I'm gonna hunt them down and murder them. Okay, mission has been accepted. Was it you? It looks so happy when it's sleeping. I just want to cuddle up and go to sleep too. you? Was it you, Daddy, and you came out of this building? Were you taking residence in here? I am mighty suspicious right now of everyone in the area. I will find the trainer and bring them to justice. And I'll probably forget about it by like next episode or 5 seconds later, but never mind that. For now, it's an important mission. Oh, what's going on down here? A trainer tips. Okay, just talking about Festival Plaza. There's a Pokeball here though. Great Sebek. Was it this surfer though? I used to be a fisherman, but after I fished up a surfboard one day, I decided to become a surfer instead. Wow, that's kind of like life just chewed right at you, didn't it, huh? Just chewed the surfing life right at you. Did you look... You still look like one of those surfer guys, too? Oh, these are some of my favorite Alolan Pokemon, because look at their luscious hair! Oh, they're so beautiful! It's living in a desert like the Hina Desert that makes you appreciate the value of an oasis. As the weakness of different types that make you really appreciate different Pokemon. I do agree. Gotta appreciate all the Pokemon because they all have their own special abilities. Actually, you know, I'm gonna go my Stoutland in case I can sniff anything out around here. Okay, so I'm supposed to go this way, but I want to check out all these areas. But you got a problem, Short Stack? I can't stand guard even. I can stand guard even when I'm squatting. I know about that. I might be able to get into that building pretty easily. Was that a trial I see up there? Actually, I think that's blocked off. But what is going on in here? You can't know who will get named a kahuna or not, youngin, until they are chosen. Even humans sometimes have to live with the whim of some capricious Pokemon. Atensko was born out of this old group that once formed around one of the old kahunas. But that old thing fell apart when they got smacked down by the Wrath of the Taboo. Oh. Interesting backstory. Oh. So people related to the kahuna got mad because the taboo is just laid down the law. Oh, the desert is like a different place every day because the winds are always moving the sand. And somewhere in that confusing mess lies the ruins of abundance. Maybe Tapu Bulu just wants to be left alone. Maybe. Oh, what the heck do you think you're doing, huh? Did someone say you could come in here? And not that I'm doing anything in here. I haven't done anything. You want to scrap? Yeah, let's fight. You what? What? No, no, no. I ain't got no time for you. I'd just be you silly anyway. Not worth it. So I'll just leave you with this. Use it to chain up and come back when you're worth my time. Oh, I love that he gives me the team taunt on purpose. I thought I got rid of you. Go and train if you want to bug me, okay? What do you want? Speaking of which, on Christmas Day yesterday, on the channels, Toy Story 3 happened to come on. What a great film. Greetings, Chalgor. I'm afraid this is the Captain's Barricade. Only those who pass the ghost type child can come chill here. And I guess I'm not going there just yet. Pawn! I don't know how to pronounce this. The Hyena Desert is like nature's own maze, but they say you can find your way to it if you keep a close eye on those stone stacks. Someone once said that the answer is 2143, but what's that? I'm gonna write this down. 2143. Alright. Got it. This is why I always have like a little pen handy. You never know when you're gonna need to write something important. Like what this old dude just told us. Alright, let's keep going. Nothing else in this area looks like. Oh, it's raining over here, Tapu Village. We're actually in Tapu Village, and I guess that's just the outskirts of the village. What's going on here? Tapu Village. The village was named that because a Tapu appeared here to protect Mount Lanakila, which reaches up so close to both the sun and moon. But all that's left of it now is the name. Hi there! Alright, let's see if I can sniff out anything in here. Sniffity sniff sniff, I ain't sniffing nothing. What a disappointment! Oh, Hal's waiting over here too. Man, the weather sure changed fast, didn't it, Hal? Phew, look, Safi. Seems like we're almost to the 8th Day house, where the captain is supposed to be, huh? So that way lies Mount Lanakila, huh? I guess they're really making a Pokemon League up there on the peak. The professor told me that Pokemon Leagues and other regions have 4 crazy strong trainers in them that they call the Elite Four. The Elite Four and our stronger. I'm pretty sure my Gramps is the strongest, but I can't wait to find out for sure. You're looking at the strongest trainer. Just wait till we take over. Hey, Alola. And Alola to you. Has Hal met these people before? Wait, he did meet them, yes. So this Tapu village, we will need to investigate it quite thoroughly. According to the records we have left to us, it seems that this is where Necrozma battled against the Tapu when it came to Alola long ago. Hungering for its light. It may be the case that the power which came pouring out of the Ultra Wormhole at that time is what changes Pokemon's regular moves into Z moves. Such theories have been suggested. Our ancestors are greedy and they sought to control all of Necrozma's light. But what was the result of that? They only hurt Necrozma, making it lose a part of itself and causing it to run wild and steal all the light it could find. That's why we have Necrozma cooped up in the Megalo Tower our great ancestors built. It contains Necrozma in its reach. But that facility has reached its limit. And Necrozma hungers for light. That is why we came to Alola in hopes of finding a new method to defeat Necrozma yet. It seems it will be a difficult mission for us, who are so new to Pokemon battling, to ever hope to defeat Necrozma. Interesting! Okay, so Necrozma isn't really evil, it was the ancestors that were greedy. And now he has no light, so he's being contained? That's horrible! I don't really get what that was all about, but it seems like those Ultra Recon Squad people are in a pretty hopeless spot, huh? I just wish everybody could be happy and find something to smile about, even that Necrozma. Right, Zevi? Oh, how so nice! My heart! He's so nice! Well, what's with that all about? Light being stolen reminds me of what happened in front of the professor's laboratory. You're right. When the screen flashed and we went out. I just wish everybody could be... Oh, that's such a cute line! Oh my gosh! Alright, so where are we gonna go from here? I guess we'll check out the Pokemon Center first. So I see you've had 125 battles against other trainers. And you're taking advantage of your abilities in battle. Now then, I wonder if you can see his victory even from me. I will. I've also experienced many battles, maybe even more than you. Now it's time to see who truly is the better trainer. Oh no, no pressure! You should have told me how many battles he had before he accepted this. Veteran Angus, what level are your Pokemon? He's got a shield on. At least it's not a Salamence just yet. Oh, it's pretty high level. Oh man, this could be tough. Oh no, I wish I had a fairy type move to use on him. I might actually switch out to Popo, because Popo's got fairy type moves. So we can take down this dragon. Oh, and Popo's got ice type moves as well, actually. So we got both covered. But we're gonna go with Disarming Voice for right now. It has higher accuracy. Let's hit this Shogun. Come on. Oh! Overhit should do it. Well, double edging. This guy's really going all out, but he's gonna hurt himself a lot in that process. We're actually a lot faster. Actually, that's not surprising. He's like a big boulder. And the critical hit. Aww. You will receive all the praise for that. Good job. That's quite the experience boost. It's like, oh, I can keep you out. You're good for this one, too. Do you got, like, all dragon types here, buddy? Oh, I love Gumi and Sligoo. I'm gonna try ice this time. Hopefully it hits. Yeah, it's hitting. Let's see how much damage this one will do. Okay, that did way less than the other one would probably do. Oh no, Thunderbolt! Why do you have Thunderbolt? I was not ready for this. Hold up, hold up. We gotta get a potion out here. We're gonna want to use it because we got some lemonade, right? Let's use that lemonade. Heal 70 HP. Hopefully that's enough. Actually, that's probably not enough. Why is it gonna have Thunderbolts of all the moves? If it didn't have Thunderbolt, we could finish this off so much quicker. Okay, maybe I should use a different type of healing item. I'll use this one. 120, that's perfect. Oh no, now I'm regretting taking this beat up. Still super effective and poisoned. Nice. It's not looking so good in my favor, and I also think I'm getting the hiccups. Oh no! It's all happening right now, isn't it? Oh, it's super effective. Still doesn't do too much, though. Oh, I'm getting worried. Maybe I should switch. Alright, so you got thunder and you got poison. Maybe I should switch in. Could Aya make good work of this enemy? Let's try switch Aya in. I think Popo's facing a lot of pressure right now. And this guy isn't taking much of my damage. Alright, at least that's like a free switch on Aya, because Aya takes nothing. Let's just try high horsepower and see how it goes. Wow, I switch Aya in and Aya just sweeps it away! Like it's nothing! Just under the rug at this point. Wow! You're not even super effective, but just so fast! Okay, goodbye. You know what? You can try to deal with this goodbye too, since you did such a good job. This guy's really into dragon types right here. Let's go with high horsepower again. Oh, you're going for earthquake? I would show you an earthquake, but for some reason I have not learned earthquake. I mean, come on, earthquake's like one of the signature moves for ground types, so where is it at? Oh, I got hurt a little bit. I think I should still be able to attack this turn, I hope so. Okay, for another earthquake, huh? How much is this gonna do? Oh, so close! We're right next to the Pokemon Center though, so as soon as we defeat this guy, we can run in, get a heal. And escape. Oh wait! Wait, no, I fainted because of the rough skin! I didn't think about that, no! What a finish to the battle! I didn't realize there was such a big difference between us and how many trainers we battled. I thought you said you battled more than me. Was that a lie too? Everything will work out if you choose to keep fighting for victory. Oh, and speaking of choice, let me give you choice specs. If a Pokemon holds them, they'll be stuck using only the first move they chose in battle, but their SP attack will be boosted by 50%. That's pretty helpful. I might want to consider using that battle after battle, even when you have to stop. It's not long before you're up and at it. Keep striving for victories. Find something there that only you can find. I can try. What are you doing? People like to say that Tapu Bulu destroyed the supermarket in a strange, but that's not right. It's the people themselves who were to blame. What did they think would happen when they built a shop on land that's sacred to the Tapu? Oh, why would they do that? People, man! I sometimes don't understand human beings! Hey, do you have a Phantom? I'll trade you. You must be wondering why I want to trade the same species. A rumor? I don't have one, but interesting. What room are you talking about? You know, some Pokemon can steal all HP from others with moves like Absorb and Mega Drain. Do you think it tastes different depending on the species of Pokemon they steal it from? That's a weird thought to have that I'd rather not consider. Pokepalago, yeah, you get Poke Beans there. I don't think I've actually visited there at all yet. You know a scientist guy named Colrus? He was bragging to you about how his wearables are cooled with water so they stay comfortable. I thought we were about to find out some real exciting information right now, but it's just Chorus and his water. We got quite a few professors in the Alola region, haven't we? Maybe something to do with a nice camp climate. Okay, nothing too exciting in the Pokemon Center. I was waiting for someone to throw items at me or something. But no items have been thrown. Not yet, at least. And I was hoping they might throw some items at me. I guess we'll head out. We won't get any tea right now. I'll come back for tea maybe a little later. Oh, so there's the path up there, but I want to check out what's going on down here. Wait, this is another route? Oh, it is another route. Alright. You got quite a few places to go from here. And now what's up here? Can I go up here just yet? Can I take a little peek? Oh, looks like we can't go up here just yet, can we not? These guys look busy. Oh yeah, they're working on construction. Yeah, so this way to making the Pokemon League, so we'll have to come back here later. I'm gonna remember this spot, and I'm gonna remember that Machamp. I feel like we should fight a Machamp in the Pokemon League, looking at the one that's right there. Oh, there's some grass here too, I wonder what's in it. First of all, the Rotom is a thing. But I wonder what Pokemon are right here. I like how they just leave this tiny patch of grass right here. Got some Rotom experience boosts, I might have to use that another time. What's going on in this grass right here? Absol! I love Absol! I used Absol when I played Shoe Pokemon X and Y. I love it so much! Oh, it's so cute! Oh, this is not a disaster Pokemon. It is a wonderful, beautiful angel. Let me try a quick ball on it. Let's see if we can sneak a catch before the end of this episode. Come on, stay, please. Maybe. Come on. Oh! Yeah, it still worked! Success! I think he appreciated my speech. Hey, we did it! Got 1,000 experience. But we gotta level up. A new Pokédex entry. Oh, so cute! I also love the movie that had Absol in it. Was it the Jirachi movie? The only thing unlucky about Absol in it is its appearance. Wait, what do you mean its appearance? Its appearance is beautiful! And it protects fields and warns people of disasters, so we'll have to be grateful for it. Yeah, isn't it kind? It warns people of disaster. It's so caring and beautiful! I like Absol a lot. It's such a majestic, elegant looking Pokemon. Well guys, I'm gonna end this episode here, so thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you all have a wonderful day, and I will see you guys again in the next episode. Bye bye! 3, 2, 1, poof!